began to grow. Days at feast began to fade. Those are the days that I'll never trade. The time it took to fall in love with you. That feast began to fade. Those are the days that I will never trade. The time it took to fall in love with you. Is not my own. This breath is not my own. This life is not my own. Oh, oh. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. Not my own. Oh, I'm not my own. Not my own. a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. Oh, not my own. Not my own. This is the place of my beginning. This is the place of my beginning. In utter dependence, in utter dependence, in utter dependence. This is a place of my beginning. This is a place of my beginning. This is a place of my beginning. In utter dependence, in utter dependence, I am yours. I am yours. I There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. There's a peace that comes to my soul when I remember you're in control. There's a joy that comes to my heart when I remember I'm not my own. This is a place of my beginning, in utter dependence, in utter dependence, in utter dependence. This is a place of my beginning. In utter dependence, in utter dependence, for the days of love began to grow. The days that fears began to fade, those are the days that I will never trade. The time it took to fall in love with you, oh, I will never trade. I will never to you. Oh, I belong to you. Oh, to you. Trust completely.
I lift up my defenses.
trust completely.
Into my defenses.
Oh, you've won my heart completely.
And I have no regrets.
You've won my trust. Set my soul at ease, and in the quiet breath of my father's, I remember who I am, and when I feel the warmth of my father's smile, feels like I've been born again. I've been born again. by the hand, walk with me by quiet streams. I need to hear the wind, feel the ground beneath my feet. 'Cause you're the only friend who could set my soul. Oh. Father's eyes, I remember who I am. And when I feel the warmth of my Father's smile, feels like I've been born again. And I'm born again. Take me to that place where nothing else matters, where nothing else matters but the pride in your eyes, the smile on your face. Where nothing else matters, where nothing else matters but the pride in your eyes. Smile of your face, and nothing else matters, and nothing else matters. But take me to that place where nothing else matters but the pride in your eyes and the smile. And all I hear are the words of his lips. Oh, till all I see is the face of my Father. And all I hear is the sound of his voice. You are my son. Son, and I am well pleased in you. You are my son. You are my son, and I am well pleased. Oh, I am well away. the shame. When you wash away all the condemnation, I am well pleased. I am well pleased. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of my sorrow. Away all of your shame, all of your shame. I am well pleased, I am well pleased, I am well pleased. For I've written your name the palms of my hands. You are not forgotten, you are not forsaken. Oh, I've written your name on the palms of my hands. You are not forgotten, you are not forsaken. You are my son.
Everything exists to lift you high, so high.
where you send it so loud. If the rocks cry out in silence so loud. If the sum of all our praise itself all shines, then we'll sing again 100 billion times.
Stars are made to worship so alive.
mountains bow in reverence, all alive. If the oceans roar your greatness, all alive. For if everything exists, still left you high, so alive. If the wind goes where you send it, so cry out in silence, so alive. If the sum of all our praises still falls shy, then we'll sing again 100 billion times. If the stars are made to worship, so so alive. If the oceans roar your greatness, so alive. For if everything exists, I left you high, so alive. If the wind goes where you send it, so alive. If the rocks cry out in silence, so alive. The sum of all our praise still falls shy, and we'll sing again 100 billion times. Oh, oh, salvation. You chased out my heart through all of my failure and pride. On a hill you created the light of the world, abandoned in darkness to die. And as you speak, 100 billion failures disappear. Where you lost your life so I could find it here. If you left the grave behind you, so alive. I can see your heart in everything you've done. Every part designed in a work of art called love. If you gladly chose surrender, so alive. I can see your heart 8 billion different ways. Every precious one, a child you died to save. You gave your life to love them, so alive. Like you would again 100 billion times. But one measure could amount to your desire. You're the one who never leaves the one behind.
Revelation 5, verses 1 to 5. Then I saw in the right hand of him who was seated on the throne a scroll written within and on the back, sealed with seven seals. And I saw a mighty angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the scroll and break its seals?" And no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth was able to open the scroll or to look into it. And I began to weep loudly because no one was found worthy to open the scroll or to look into it. And one of the elders said to me, "Weep no more. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has conquered so that he can open the scroll and its seven seals. Holy Spirit, come and awaken us today to the worthiness of Jesus. Sweep us up in the reality of heaven and give us new eyes to see this passage and this truth. There is only one who will be found worthy in all of heaven and earth and under the earth to open the scroll and to look in it. It is because you conquered, Jesus, and did what no one else could ever do. You lived a sinless life. You died sacrificially for us. You rose again in victory. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Even now, you have all authority over death, hell, sin, and the grave. You and you alone are truly worthy and deserving of the highest praise and honor that we could ever give you. And so we come today, God, to pour out our praises and to worship you in spirit and in truth. For you and you alone are worthy, God.
all glory and all praise.
You are worthy, Jesus.
He is worthy of all glory and all praise.
All the glory is yours.
He is worthy of all glory and all praise. The Lion and the Lamb. Oh, the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, the Lion and the Lamb. Oh, the Lion and the Lamb.
Oh, the Lion and the Lamb. The roof is the temple.
Revelation 5, verses 6 to 10. And between the throne and the four living creatures, and among the elders, I saw a lamb standing, as though it had been slain, with seven horns and with seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, sent out into all the earth. And he went and took the scroll from the right hand of him who was seated on the throne. And when he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each holding a harp and golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, worthy are you to take the scroll and to open its seals. For you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed people for God from every tribe and language and people and nation. And you have made them a kingdom and priests to our God. And they shall reign on the earth. Jesus, we owe everything we have to you. You ransomed us and with your blood rescued us out of the kingdom of darkness and brought us to live in the kingdom of light. You died to end our separation, to end the separation of people from every tribe and language and people and nation. You're amazing. And you long to know us each intimately and personally. And you did it to make a people who live loving and trusting you. You did it so we could reign with you. And and we can partner with you to bring heaven to this earth. What kind of love is this, Almighty God? We are truly in awe of you today, and with everything in us, God, we say thank you. Worthy are you, O Lord. Worthy are you, O Lord.
The Lord, they will sing,
The redeemed of the Lord, they will sing, they will sing. Oh, the redeemed of the Lord, they will sing, they will sing. The redeemed of the Lord, they will sing, they will sing. The redeemed of the Lord, they will sing, they will sing. The redeemed of the Lord, they will sing, they will sing a new song. Oh, to the one who's worthy, they will sing a new song. To the one who is worthy from every tribe and every tongue and every people and nation. This new song will arise. Worthy are you, God. 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 Worthy are you, God.
Revelation 5, verses 11 to 14. Then I looked, and I heard around the throne, and the living creatures and the elders, the voice of many angels, numbering myriads of myriads and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing." And I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea and all that is in them saying, "To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor and glory and might forever and ever." And the four living creatures said, "Amen." And the elders fell down and worshiped. Almighty God, today we join with the living creatures, elders, and myriads of angels as we cry with everything in us, "Worthy are you, Almighty God, to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing." With everything in us, we say, "Take it all. You are deserving. You alone are worthy." We declare that you are sovereign and rule and reign over all. You reign over every earthly kingdom and institution, and they must bow to you, for you alone are the King. You have no rival. You have no equal. You alone are God, and we worship you today.
The stars are made to worship so so alive. If the oceans roar your greatness, so will I. For if everything exists to lift you high, so will I. If the wind goes where you send it, so will I. If the rocks cry out in silence, so will I. Fall shall shine. Then we'll sing again 100 billion times. If the stars are made to worship, so will I. If the mountains bow in reverence, so will I. Oh, if the oceans roar your greatness, so will I. For if everything exists to lift you high, so will I. If the rocks cry out in silence, so will I. If the someone cries silence, so will I. If the sum of all our praises still fall shy, then we'll sing again 100 billion times. Oh, 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 oh. To him who sits on the throne, and to the Lamb be blessing and honor, and glory and power. To him who sits on the throne, and to the Lamb be blessing and honor, and glory and power forever and ever. Forever.
Almighty God, we thank you so much for this glimpse into the heavenly realms today that you have given us. And we thank you for the deposit that you have placed in each one of us as we have come and gazed upon your face. And we're reminded again that you are the only one who is worthy, and that all of the things in our lives that try to take that place have all fallen to the side. And once again, your throne is established in each of our lives. God, I pray that you would release new songs of worship from us, not just throughout the nations, but from us as well. God, that we would constantly be brought back to this passage and reminded once again the honor and the privilege we have of joining in with the myriads and the angels and the elders to worship, to adore. I pray, God, that adoration would flow from our lips with so much more ease than they have in the past, and that we would not be able to get away from this image of seeing you high and lifted up. Pray that our lives would be realigned by your word and by being in your presence in this way today. We thank you, God, and ask you to seal what you've done, how you've moved, what you've spoken. And we pray, God, that you've received it all as beautiful incense and as a beautiful gift from our heart to yours. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
From the end glory to the righteous one. From the ends of the earth, you hear our song. Glory to the righteous one. Oh, from the ends of the earth, you hear our song. To the righteous one, from the ends of the earth, you hear our song. Glory to the righteous one. From every nation, tongue, and tribe will be to you a spotless bride, and this song that we now raise is hastening the day when every nation, tongue, and tribe will be to you a spotless bride. And this song that we now raise is hastening the day when every nation, tongue, and tribe will be to you a spotless bride. And this song that we now raise is hastening the day when every nation, tongue, and tribe will be to you a spotless bride. And this song that we now raise is hastening the day. Oh, we're hastening the day.
And this song that we now raise
is hastening the day when every nation, tongue, and tribe will be to you a spotless bride. And this song that we now raise is hastening the day when every nation, tongue, and tribe will be to you a spotless bride. And this song that we now raise is hastening the day, and you will have your inheritance, Jesus, starting with
to a time of intercession through prayer topics. This morning, we'll be praying for Korea. Specifically, we will be praying for the church in Korea. Please come into agreement with me as I pray with the prayer points on the screen, and then raise intercession with your own voice as the Spirit leads you to pray through each topic. Almighty God, we know that you love the Korean church so much. Your love for her is fiery and passionate. It is no accident that the Pyeongchang Olympics is using the term Passion Connect for their motto. This is the cry of every Korean heart to connect passionately, to be loved passionately, and to live passionately. You place that desire so that they would want to passionately connect with you. But many don't know this kind of passion in your church. They only know dry rule following, or lifeless obedience. And this is not okay. You want so much more for your Korean bride. So we lift her up today to you. Bring her into the fullness of a passionate relationship with you. You knew her and loved her first. You are truly her first love. Lord, remove the hindrances to her really knowing your fiery love. Expose the lies that have creeped in about you and how you see your bride. We bind all fear and declare that your love is rushing into every place that was held by fear. You are setting the captives free. We pray, God, that you would chase down each of your children with your relentless love, bringing an end to all addictions, obsessions, idolatry, desperation, hopelessness, depression, and suicide. We prophesy every hard, cold, apathetic, bitter, and wounded heart in the church is being encountered by the fire of God's love right now. Your fiery love is forever changing them, restoring them, and healing them. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, I have personally been challenged so much by the way that your sons and daughters in Korea spend time reading and memorizing your word. It is amazing to hear of people who will sit down and read of the Bible from cover to cover over a few days, or those who are working hard to memorize parts of your word to hide in their hearts. God, today we pray that you will activate and bring to life those scriptures that have been read, memorized, hidden, and heard. Let your word read each of your servants and realign their perspectives on life, on godliness, on you. May they open their mouths to make a comment and the truth of your word flows out instead. Give us experiences like that. May your word break into their thoughts and bring the revelation and wisdom they need in the middle of worrying and times of anxiety. Stir up a hunger in all of your sons and daughters to know your word and the God who inspired it. We declare that the word of God is being given the place of priority in every believer's life. Far over media, far over money, far over social position and beauty, we declare that the word of God is being given place and priority in every son and daughter of God's life. And we prophesy that Bible teachers who know the Lord intimately and humbly with integrity will be raised up to teach the Korean bride to see you rightly through your word. Let us pray. Lord, you have been so good to your church. It is amazing that you have put in your people the very giftings and callings that our communities need to grow in godliness and to be victorious in spiritual warfare. Today we pray for the Korean bride to come into the full understanding of the importance of these spiritual giftings and spiritual callings. Natural giftings and natural callings as well, for they're all gifts from the Father of lights. They're all gifts from your hand of goodness. May each and every son and daughter of yours here in Korea grow to understand their great significance in the kingdom of God and the importance of their gifts uniquely, personally, passionately. Activate new spiritual giftings and callings in this new season that bring hope and life to the body. Give her the grace to generously use her gifts to bless others and to receive the blessings from others. We bind all voices of elitism, entitlement, comparison, and condemnation, keeping the Korean bride from walking in her divine destiny and calling. We declare that the unique dreams that you have placed in your sons and daughters that have been dead are coming back to life as new mindsets replace old mindsets once again. And we prophesy that you are breathing life on your servants and that their spiritual giftings are being revealed in this hour with wisdom and understanding. Let us pray. Father, as we spend more time with you, we naturally become more like you, and we start to care about the things on your heart. This is our prayer for the Korean church in this new year. We pray that you will intimately make your passions and desires known to her, and that she will take great delight in partnering with you as you heal the broken. As your people live their everyday walking around lives, whisper to them and share the passions and burdens you feel. Let this new access to intimacy send shockwaves throughout all of Korea as your bride takes on those passions and burdens as her own. We declare that waves of compassion are being poured out on the Korean bride that will result in legislation changes regarding adoption and the care of the elderly. We pray that the Korean bride will look to see where you are moving, Heavenly Father, and then partner with you both locally and globally. We prophesy that the Lord is raising up sons and daughters with integrity and empathy who will demonstrate the love of Jesus through their actions and their lives. Let us pray.
An army rising up. There's an army rising up to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There's an army rising up.
Raise up your army, Lord.
There's an army rising up
with more power, with more fire.
There's an army rising up to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. We see an army rising up. We see an army rising up in
strengthen
this nation.
Your army. Strengthen.
There's an army rising up to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain.
Lord, you are truly raising up an army here of your sons and daughters here in Korea. We pray that as you raise up this army, that they would be lovers first of you, deeply rooted in the love of the Father, knowing their place, knowing who they are, that they would come into the understanding of their identity, their significance. That you would bless them with all of the greatest things. that you would take them on a beautiful journey, growing a hunger inside of them for your word, equipping them with spiritual giftings and callings. And as you equip your army here in Korea, that it wouldn't be a burden, it wouldn't be a strain, but it would be joy that they go out in, that it would be love, it would be passion, it would be sincerity. Because they were loved first, they would have so much love to pour out. We thank you, God, that you have new things for the church in Korea in this year. We thank you that you are doing away with the old things and that you are bringing in your new things. And we stand in agreement and say, yes, God, yes, only the best for your Korean bride. Only the best for your Korean bride. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.